Hi everyone, my name is Rachel and welcome to The French Seams. Thanks very much for joining me again for another video. This is a Friday Sews video. So as always, a huge thanks to Jen from Today in Jen Sewing Room for setting up this lovely hashtag. So it feels like absolutely ages since I've done a vlog. So I think it's been well over a month since I did that Friday Sews roundup of my week off, and I really, really enjoyed making that. And thank you so much to everybody who's watched it. I got some really, really great feedback on it. So thank you so much. I really hope you enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed making it. So as always, a huge thank you to everybody who's watched any of my previous videos, anybody who's liked them, anybody who's left a comment, or anybody who has subscribed. So thank you very, very much. You know how much it means to me. So I have had a little flurry of new subscribers, so you're all very, very welcome. And if you're a regular viewer here, then welcome back. So this is going to be a little catch up on everything I've done in the kind of the last month, really. So I've quite a bit to get through. So I've made a couple of things. I'll tell you about what I've been up to, and then I'll give you a little idea of my plans for the next few weeks. So let's get started. What have I been making? So if anybody watches my channel, they know how much I feel about, or how much I love flamingos. And I bought this beautiful fabric from Crafty Studio a good while ago, actually, when I was up there for one of the Dublin meetups. So I made the MET, which I am completely addicted to now. It's the Jennifer Lauren pattern. You can make it with a plain front, or you can colour block the front. And this is now my third version. I think it only came out about 6 weeks ago. So beautiful grown on sleeves with a little band cuff, and then I finally got the length right on it. So very, very happy with this. I think it's super, super cute. For all of these makes, I'll go through them properly in my summer makes vlog, which will come sometime at the end of the summer. But if you do have any questions on these, just please feel free to leave me a comment below. I should mention what I'm wearing today. We've been having lovely warm weather in Dublin, which makes me very, very happy. So I've been wearing, this is the Tilly in the Buttons Tabitha t-shirt, which comes from her stretch book, I believe. And in this beautiful yellow fabric that I got from EcoBee that I made last summer, was the summer before, when I went through a massive like t-shirt making phase. It was brilliant. So I love this t-shirt. It's such a beautiful colour. And I'm wearing my little sewing machine necklace, which if you watched my previous video, I bought this little, I think it's a charm, in a beautiful little quilting shop, and I've made it into a little necklace, and I love it. And people do comment on it as well, which is really, really nice. So this is the first thing I got done a couple of weeks ago. The next thing is my Gilbert shirt. So I'll put these on a hanger, actually might be easier. Well, I'll see what I can do. This is my Cherry Gilbert shirt. So I love this pattern. It's a Helen's Closet pattern, and I found this remnant on the Carlo Fabrics website a couple of weeks ago, and it was 1.25 meters, which is the perfect amount. So I was able to get a short sleeve version and the little tie front, and it just came out perfectly. I absolutely love it. So I think I could probably get out a sleeveless version out of a meter, which is interesting. I just absolutely love this. It's beautiful fabric. The little cherries are just gorgeous. I love this pattern, the burrito yoke, the way she does it, the fully enclosed collar, yoke, everything. It's such a clever construction, and the little tie. And this was during when my sewing machine was off sick. It's since come back. Thank you very, very much to sewingmachines.ie down in Waterford for fixing my lovely Juki. It's right here. So this was with my old brother machine. And of course, I had put all my bits and bobs from my brother into the Juki, because it's got a little drawer at the front. So I had sent my button foot, unbeknownst to me, down to Waterford. So I was like, oh, what'll I do? And then I tried this on, and I'm able to get this on over my head. So I didn't need buttonholes. So these are all just sewn on, which is wonderful. So they're little bright red cherry buttons, and they're all just sewn on, and I can pull it on over my head. So I didn't need to do buttonholes, which is wonderful. So I absolutely love this t-shirt, or this shirt, I should say. And this has given me plans that I would love to make one of these shirts with the Tilly in the Buttons Lotus skirt, to make it into a little kind of shirt dress for summer. I think it would look super cute. So I'm on the hunt for some really lovely cotton lawn maybe to make it out of, but love this pattern. Absolutely love it. The next was a bit of a fail. So the pattern is fabulous. It is the swimming towels that I wanted to make for my boys after swimming. So this is a Style Arc pattern. I think it's called the Coral Kids swimming towel or something like that. I'll pop everything down below as always. So, and I made this for my older boy. And if I show it to you, it looks great. It's got the little hood, and it's just a towel like this. It's lovely toweling fabric from Vibes and Scribes. I made my own bias binding using the continuous bias binding method. So I can get 4 meters of bias binding out of 1 fat quarter, which is pretty cool. It is probably some of the worst sewing I've ever done in my whole entire life. I'm actually embarrassed to show this to you. So the bias binding is just shocking. I couldn't decide whether I wanted to stitch in the ditch, whether I wanted the exposed stitching, so I kind of did a mix of the two. I kept missing things, so it's not really caught. I didn't have any matching thread, so I used just random thread. So it's pink and red binding with navy stitching. It's just terrible. It's just the worst sewing I've ever done, which is no reflection on the pattern. It's entirely a reflection of me. I think I just got in a mood then doing it and just ended up just getting really, really cross. So I want to give this another go because I know I can do better. So I'm going to make more binding. I'm going to take down this area of the towel a little bit because it's a little bit low. This is for my older boy. He's 4 and I think I made him, I think it's a 4 to 7 age or something, but it's slightly too big. So I really want to get this done properly. If you have any tips on sewing bias binding, please let me know because I have made a complete hash up of this. It's just awful and I really want to improve. So yes, my bias binding is just, it's beautiful bias binding, but it's appalling sewing. It really is. So I think we'll move swiftly on from this make and let's talk no more about it, shall we? Excellent. So moving on very quickly, this is a make that was successful and this is beautiful fabric that I got from Beyond the Pink Door when I went to Andrea's fabulous sewing retreat, and it's beautiful rainbowy fabric, and this is the Itch to Stitch Lego Tank, which is a free pattern and I just love it. So the weather was beautiful and warm last weekend. I got to wear this and it just feels so lovely, so light and summery. Random bits of thread as always, and I think I did pretty good on the stripe matching on the side seam. So look at that. I think that's pretty good going. What do you think? It's pretty good going. So yes, fabulous pattern. This is now my second or third one of these tank tops and it's just great. I love it. Another Beyond the Pink Door make, because I think I bought 5 pieces of fabric at Andrea's, is the Nina Lee Mayfair dress. This is my second Mayfair dress. My first one was in a beautiful mustardy kind of glittery fabric from Crafty Studio. This is a beautiful kind of maroony colour with these lovely rose gold, it's covered in fluff, rose gold little flowers, which are beautiful. It's a gorgeous construction. It's got this lovely shawl collar, which is all enclosed at the back. Absolutely beautiful. Then it's got this gather tie detail. The last time I made this, I cut it out incorrect. And I ended up having to have a waist seam, but I managed to hide it with the band. But it meant that my waist didn't really fit where the waist seam was. So this time I did it properly by following the instructions like a good little sewer. And so it fits much, much better. And I just love this little tie. It goes all the way around. And I did the knee length version. And I think this dress is just beautiful. I think all these are up on my Instagram account if you want to take a quick peek, or this will be very shortly anyway. But yeah, just love it. And this is perfect for work. Even though it's long sleeve, it's cotton jersey, so it's still very, very comfortable. And I think you can probably get away with this during the summer. But then also this is going to be fabulous at Christmas because it's a perfect Christmassy colour. Next up is another Beyond the Pink Door fabric, and you can see my love affair with yellow is continuing. So here we go. This is a more kind of paler yellow, and this is, I think it's faux angora fabric, and it is beautiful. It's so gorgeous. It's almost got a marley color to it, and I think she has this in a couple of colors. It's absolutely beautiful. This is the Jennifer Lauren Juniper cardigan, which is so much nicer than I thought it was. When I looked at the pattern, I was like, oh, it's a really nice cardigan. It's really cute. And then, of course, I saw the lovely Lorianne wearing her Juniper cardigan. And it's got the most beautiful saddle shoulder detail, which I didn't actually realise. So it's a really funky construction. You can kind of see the saddle shoulder there. So there's a little bit of clear elastic in there to help it keep its shape. The pattern is meant for more kind of stable fabrics, and this is quite a drapey make, but it still worked out really, really well. And it's a lovely, just a standard cardigan, and it came out really well and pretty quick. The one thing about this is that it does have buttons. I have got my Dookie back at this stage, so I was able to do buttonholes-ish. So the pattern asks you to put twill tape on the back, which is really cool. I think it gives it great stability. And I put 4 buttons on this and I have a 50% success rate of my buttonholes. 2 of them are really good. 2 of them don't open because my machine had a total meltdown and just did not want to do buttonholes on this fabric. And to be honest, I don't blame it. It's quite fluffy, which makes it lovely, lovely soft. And my machine was like, nope. I don't want to do that. Thank you very much. I've made you 2 buttonholes. I'm not going to do the other 2. So We won't fall out over it, it's fine. But I do have nice little yellow buttons on the other side. So I really like this. I think it's a really, really cute make. And I would highly recommend this pattern. I'm definitely going to make more of these in future. I think I made a size, I'll put it down below, I can't quite remember, but I do remember that I added 2 inches to the bodice length, and it still comes up quite cropped on me. So it is a very, very short pattern. I made the short version, but it's an absolutely beautiful pattern. I really, really love it. And there'll be more Juniper cardigans in my future. The last of the Beyond the Pink Door fabrics that I made up, I think I have one more that I want to do a heather blazer in, but that'll probably come later in the summer, is my shorts. So there's a story about these, and I won't bore you now. I'll go into it in my makes video, but these are the Love Notions Caye shorts. So shorts like this, again, they have fluff on them, and then the back is elasticated. So these were a journey. So the fabric is beautiful. It was so nice to work with, absolutely gorgeous, and I just adore the colour. So I made a straight size 14 on these, and they came out almost like a skirt on me. They just flared out of the bottom. So I had to take in each side by about 6 centimetres and take out the inner leg by about 4 centimetres on each leg, which is quite a big amount of fabric, really. It was also a huge amount of fabric to unpick, because I had put on the cuff, I had overlocked it, and I had understitched it. So I had to take off everything, take out a wedge on either side of the leg, and sew it up again, redo the cuff and reattach them. But I'm so pleased that I did, because they now fit really, really well. Did I map out those adjustments back to the paper pattern? No. So when I make these again, I'll have the same nightmare, and I'll have to remember what I did and what kind of a wedge I took out. But they're absolutely beautiful now, and I love them. The waistband lining is just scraps that I had. You'll recognise the little cherries, just scraps that I had. Didn't really have anything suitable. And then the main story comes with the pockets. So this is fabric left over from a Stevie top that I made last year, which I love. So there is, and I did actually write this down so I wouldn't forget, in my trusty little notebook that I have here. So in this pattern, there's a pocket bag and there's a front pocket lining. Both of them are cut in the fold, and both of them put across the front of the shorts. I had assumed that you would see the pocket bag and you wouldn't see the lining. It's actually the other way around. So this is actually, my notebook's gonna fall. This part is actually called the lining, which I had assumed would be that bit. So I had assumed that you wouldn't see this bit, and that would just be green, and then the stripes would be in the inside. I was very, very wrong, and I found out very late in the game. But I don't think it necessarily matters. At least they match, but I did want this to be green again, but never mind. Hey ho, you live and learn. And I'm not going to wear a t-shirt tucked into these. I'm going to wear the t-shirt over it, so I don't think you're particularly notice. But I was very, very cross with myself for making that mistake. But anyway, yes, but I love these shorts, and I will actually make more of these. I put on a nice little rosy cheeks label. The back pockets are in the perfect position. The crotch rise and everything is absolutely perfect. That there was no finished measurements on it, but yeah, the fit is actually perfect, and the length was perfect. Didn't do anything to the length. It was just purely the kind of the flared out nature of them, which kind of surprised me. But we got there in the end, and I'm very, very pleased with them. And I have actually worn them quite a bit since, which is always a bonus. And that was my main thing about making shorts, to make them early in the summer so I'd get the benefit of them. The last little thing I made in the last month is this little t-shirt for older French seams. So I have recently bought a few things from Ecobee, which I'll show you very shortly, and she usually sends out little bits of chocolate or a little treat, but she hasn't been recently, and instead she sent out little panels, which is really, really cool and really generous. Thank you so much, Elvie. So, and I got this little panel here, and of course my older boy loved it as soon as he saw it. So he then wanted a t-shirt. Obviously he wanted a t-shirt the next day to go to creche wearing, so I managed to palm him off for I think maybe 2-3 days, I think. So I was able to make him a little t-shirt. I'd never used a panel before. It's basically just a little section, a little rectangle with the picture in the middle, and then this fabric top and bottom. And I just then folded it in half down the middle, and was able to cut the front bodice of this on the fold, and there you go with your little panel. So it's really, really cute. I did find this charcoal fabric that I had in my stash, which actually is Ecobee as well, so it matches perfectly. And this is the Waves and Wild Adventure Raglan. It comes as a sweatshirt pattern, but I just cut off the sleeves and I didn't put on the waistband, and makes a very, very cute t-shirt, and he loved wearing it. And he can't quite decide if it's a crocodile or a dinosaur. It is a crocodile, but he can pretend it's a dinosaur as well, and everybody's happy. So this is very, very cute. So thank you very much for that. And they were all my makes. So a whistle stop tour of all of those. I loved making them. Some of them a little more stressful than others, I'm not going to lie, but that's all part and parcel. I think just don't sew late at night. Don't sew when you're tired, the usual, and maybe look up a few YouTube videos about how to sew unbiased binding, I think is my takeaway, really. So what else do I have to tell you? I'm conscious that this video is going to be a little bit long. On the life side of things, which is what Friday Sews is also about, we went on a lovely trip to the south coast of England a few weeks ago, which is why I was able to wear my lovely new shorts. So that was really, really nice. We went away for a long weekend, the four of us. The weather was absolutely spectacular. It was a complete bucket and spade holiday. The two boys loved it, playing in the sand, playing at the beach all day, every day. It was just fabulous. And yes, the weather just makes such a difference. Beautiful blue skies, glorious sunshine. It was just fabulous. But however, I was wearing these beautiful new green shorts, and I also decided it would be a good idea to wear a white t-shirt, the little one that I made recently with a little watermelon patch in it. And of course you say, oh, I'm going to go get an ice cream. So I got a chocolate ice cream, which I shared with my 2-year-old, who then wanted to be carried. So I was feeding him chocolate ice cream, and of course got chocolate ice cream all over my t-shirt. I knew there was a big patch here. I didn't realise until I got home that later that day, after I'd been on a plane, that he had also put chocolate ice cream on the back. So after about 4 goes to the washing machine, I've managed to get the t-shirt back relatively white again, which is wonderful. So yes, don't wear a white t-shirt on holidays with small children and chocolate ice cream, although the chocolate ice cream was delicious. That was our little trip away, which is really, really nice. As I said, we've been having beautiful warm weather in Dublin, and just that just makes me so happy. I just love the warm weather. I'm just such a cold creature usually, and any bit of sunshine, any bit of warmth, I just love it. So I've been really, really enjoying it, and long may it last, fingers crossed. We had a very good week in the French team's household. My older boy graduated from preschool, so that was fabulous. Little cap and gown pictures, and he was singing songs. It was just fabulous. But that also means that he's starting school in September. So yeah, I'm getting a little bit emotional about it already. But yeah, he's well able for school now, but it's going to be a new little chapter in his life, which is really, really good. And we're all looking forward to it. And I think he kind of understands what's going to happen in September. We keep kind of telling him about big school and things, so he should be okay. But yeah, we got his little uniform and everything. He looks absolutely adorable. Another thing that's happening this week is I am going to a crafty studio summer sewing social. So I think it's next Friday. I've taken a cheeky day off work, and up in Crafty Studio, which is about a half hour drive away from here for me, you bring your sewing machine and work on a little project for the whole morning, which I'm super excited about. I can't wait to go do a bit of sewing, have a bit of a chat, which is lovely. I'm sure I'll buy some fabric when I'm up there, and I'll show you what I want to work on when I'm there, which is also very exciting because I've got a few plans now that I can share with you as well. The last thing is that it is my birthday next week. So yes, another year older, another year wiser. And the sainted Mr. French Seams has bought me a Cricut machine. So if anybody saw my Instagram stories, I think maybe last week, I put out a kind of a poll asking, did anybody have one? What would they recommend? So in the end, we decided on the Cricut Joy, and it came with a little bundle. So for anybody who doesn't know what a Cricut machine is, I'll link it below. It's kind of a cutting tool, I think you'd call it. You can cut out vinyl for sticking on things like mugs and bottles and stuff. You can cut out iron-on transfers, so if you want to do a slogan on a t-shirt. It does card cutting out. I think some of the other ones cut out fabric. They might cut out leather, things like that. So it's really, really cool. I'll put in a link, as I say, below. Check out their Instagram page. It's really, really cool. There's some fabulous projects. I've kind of been wanting one for a couple of years. I just think they're really, really cool. And I'm very, very lucky now that it's upstairs in a box that I'm not allowed to touch until next week. So I'll be sure to share those, because people actually did say that they'd be interested to see which one I actually got in the end. So thank you very, very much to my lovely hubby for buying such a wonderful prezi for me for my birthday. Totally spoiled. Thank you so much. So I can't wait to see what's inside the box and get cracking on a few projects. So yeah, I'll now be wearing slogans all over my t-shirts. It'll be fabulous. So that's my life update. And then on the plan side, if I scoot back, so I have So I'll show you what I want to get done at the social next week. So we're in June and I really want to take part in the So Fruity 23 challenge hosted by Blossom Sandwich. Again, I'll link that below. It's basically to sew up a fruity fabric or a fruity inspired fabric in the month of June. So the sewing social is on the 30th of June, so I'm cutting it a little bit fine, but I would like to make a little bag. And the pattern that I chose is the hipster pouch from Adam Sews. It's a kind of a crossbody bag. It looks really, really cool. And I have this beautiful blueberry fabric that my mum gave me years ago, and I just love it. I think it's beautiful colours. So I went on a little bit of a spree to buy hardware. So I got these lovely zips from Ecobee. So I think the colour of those look really great. There's a zip across the top and a zip across the front. And then from Quilt Yarn Stitch, I got the webbing. So this is for the actual strap. Then I have D-rings. I have sliders. And I have, are they lobster clasps? These little swivel ones. So that's all the hardware. And then I got this, which I had never used before, and I'm hoping I got the right one, which is bag foam. So I think this is kind of a stabilizing kind of thing, but it's really cool because I do enjoy making bags. As you can see, I also made this one this week from lovely fabric from the sewing warehouse the day that I met the lovely Agatha down there. So I just made up that this week and I really like it. So now in future I might put a little bag foam in the base of my bags to give them a little bit more stability in the bottom. So looking forward to starting this pattern. I think you get the dimensions and you cut it out, you can quilt it. So I'm really, really looking forward to getting cracking on that because I do enjoy making bags. There might be bias binding on it. Oh dear. Anyway, so the other things I've got cut out are my queue dress in the lovely ice cream fabric, and I just have to do a bit of fitting on the bodice. It's quite a short bodice, so I've had to lengthen the pattern a bit, so I'm just kind of working out the sizing on it. I have a couple of weeks to finish that though before the event that I want to wear it to. I still have my magnolia dress cut out and I'm scared to sew it up, so I really have to have a little talk to myself to get that done pretty soon because I want to wear that to a wedding at the end of July. Then the last thing I would like to get done over the next week, if the weather does stay nice, is my Sunday romper. I mentioned that in my plans video. It's a Love Notions pattern, so I'm going to make the shorts. It's got an elasticated waist and then I'm just going to do the short sleeves, and I think it's a really, really cute pattern, and that's why I bought stuff from Ecobee, and that's why I got the panel, is because I chose fabric for it, which I didn't have in my plans video. And I chose this. So it's a cotton jersey and it's bluey stripes, and these are kind of yellowy spots and navy spots and white spots, and it's really, really nice. It's a lovely weight to it, and I figured that it would be relatively easy to do any kind of stripe matching, that it's not that fine a stripe, but it's just really, really pretty. Kind of reminds me of kind of waves or water or kind of summer and stuff, so I thought this would be perfect. So I'm really keen to get started on my romper. So yes, I've got the pattern printed out. I just need to stick it out and cut it out and sew it. So watch this space. So that is everything. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for stopping by. I really do appreciate it. I hope you all have a very lovely weekend. I hope to get this up to you on Friday, tomorrow. Hopefully I can get it edited this evening. I really hope you're well. Please let me know what you're working on. If you have any advice on anything I've mentioned, on my bias binding, for example. I hope you're all well, and I hope you have some time to do some lovely sewing. I hope you get some nice weather where you are. I also hope you're enjoying the sewing bee. I know I certainly am. So I watched the episode last night and I really, really enjoyed it. And I can't believe there's only 3 or 4 episodes left. It just goes by so quickly. So thank you very, very much again for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and please consider subscribing. And I will see you all again very, very soon. Take care. Bye.